हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंत फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 81। ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म Amazon Prime विल नॉट अलाउ यूजर्स टू बाय 1 month सब्सक्रिप्शन प्लान्स वर्थ ₹129। द कंपनी हैज आल्सो डिसकंटिन्यूड द फ्री Amazon Prime ट्रायल पैक एज वेल। दिस हैज बीन डन टू कंप्लाई विद रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडियाज न्यू गाइडलाइंस। द RBI हैज ऑर्डर्ड बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस टू ऐड अ फैक्टर ऑफ ऑथेंटिकेशन टू प्रोसेस रिकरिंग ऑनलाइन ट्रांजैक्शंस। द डेडलाइन फॉर द सेम इज ऑन फ्रॉम सेप्टेंबर 30th। E-commerce major Amazon is launching an ad-supported video streaming service, Mini TV, only for its Indian audience. In the first of its kind move globally, Mini TV will be available within Amazon shopping app of Android phone users. With the launch, Amazon will now have two video streaming offerings, Mini TV and Prime Video. While Prime Video will continue to remain ad-free bundled with Prime subscription, Mini TV is a free service which will not require a separate application. The company said that Mini TV will be extended to iOS and mobile web over the coming months. On the content side, Mini TV will have professionally created and curated content including web series, comedy show, tech news, food, beauty, fashion and other content. This is totally exclusive. We have gotten access to the actual Google Play Store link of the Battlegrounds Mobile India's application. This link can only be opened by applying a certain trick, or you can say by altering certain things in the Google Play Store application. Most importantly, this link is now accessible via any mobile tab of Android origin. Battlegrounds Mobile India pre-registration is starting from May 18th in India. Facebook-owned instant messaging giant WhatsApp encountered a massive backlash in January after rolling out a new privacy policy. The social media giant wanted users to accept the updated policy, which explicitly stated WhatsApp would be sharing user information with its parent company Facebook. As a result, many WhatsApp users started fleeing to other privacy-focused alternatives such as Telegram and Signal. According to data collected by Sensor Tower Store Intelligence, WhatsApp global installs declined 43% year-over-year in the first 4 months of 2021. However, it still managed to stay ahead of its competitors by reaching overall 172.3 million downloads. Electronic vehicle startup Simple Energy to launch flagship electric scooter on August 15th. Simple Energy's electric scooter, codename Mark II, was scheduled for launch in mid-2021 but has been delayed due to the ongoing second wave of COVID-19 pandemic in India. It will debut in Bengaluru in the first phase and later launch in Chennai and Hyderabad. Simple Energy said in a statement on Saturday the company will expand to more cities later on. Pre-booking will start on the launch day itself, followed by the delivery soon. And leaked database can potentially lead to unauthorized transactions from accounts of Flipkart customers who also use grocery platform BigBasket with common user ID and passwords. An independent cybersecurity expert said on Wednesday, cyber criminals are selling sets of email address and passwords of customers from leaked database of BigBasket that match with accounts of e-commerce firm Flipkart and Amazon. However, he said that Amazon sends OTP for login where there is a change in browsers. It seems that some people are selling BigBasket email password combination as Flipkart data. People are using the same passwords for all websites. Almost all emails are matching with BigBasket database. Change your Flipkart passwords as early as possible. He also said that Flipkart should secure its accounts. Anyone with the combination of leaked email and password can easily login from anywhere, including VPN to Flipkart. Please mandatory two-factor authentication for all the accounts. Most of the Instagram features have been exclusive to its mobile application, including one of its core functionalities, the ability to create and edit posts. Well, there's been a trend for the past year or so to expand the desktop Instagram site. According to the developer and tipster on Twitter, Instagram is about to let you create and edit posts from the desktop site. Xiaomi launched the Redmi Note 10 series earlier this year in India. The three phones under the budget smartphone series were available via flash sales. Xiaomi has made the Redmi Note 10 Pro 6GB and 64GB variant is available for purchase via open sales starting today. A man from India had quite a lucky day earlier this week as he placed an order of mouthwash from Amazon and received a smartphone instant. Twitter user Lokesh Daga tagged Amazon India in his post and shared a screenshot of his order as well as a picture of the Redmi Note 10 that he had received in place of its original order. Lokesh Daga have placed an order for 4 Colgate mouthwash bottles priced at ₹396 on Amazon. On May 10, the Redmi Note 10 that he received is worth ₹13,000. And he sent a mail to Amazon in and ordered a Colgate mouthwash via order number, and instead of that he got a Redmi Note 10. Since mouthwash is a consumable product, returns are restricted and unable to request to return via application. Lokesh Daga said in his post on Twitter. Poco recently announced that Poco M3 Pro 5G arriving on May 19th will be powered by the Dimensity 700 processor. Now we learn the smartphone will sport a 6.5 inch dot display with full HD plus resolution and a 90Hz refresh rate. Additionally, Poco also confirmed that M3 Pro 5G will pack a 5000mAh battery with 18W charging support. Elon Musk has shown again he can influence the digital currency market within just his tweets. After saying that his electric vehicle making company Tesla will not accept payments in Bitcoin because of environmental issues, he tweeted that he was working with developers of Dogecoin to improve system transaction efficiency. Following the two distant statements from him, the world's largest cryptocurrency hit a 2-month low while Dogecoin railed out about 20%. The SpaceX CEO has in recent months often tweeted in support of Dogecoin but rarely for Bitcoin. Realme 7i is a cheaper version of the vanilla Realme 7. The smartphone debuted with the Realme UI based on Android 10. The company released the Android 11 based Realme UI 2.0 early access update for the handset in February. Now 3 months later, the phone has started receiving the stable updates. Asus launched the Asus ZenFone 8 series including the ZenFone 8 and ZenFone 8 Flip globally earlier this week. The Asus ZenFone 8 series devices are expected to launch in India, but the devices might carry a different moniker in the country comparing to the global market. To those unaware, due to branding lawsuit against the company in 2019, the brand has launched the Asus ZenFone 6 as the Asus 6Z in India. Looks like the brand has not solved the branding lawsuit. As a consequence, Asus might launch the Asus ZenFone 8 as Asus 8Z in India. At least the Google Play support device listing hints the same. Lee Echo earlier this year when it announced a pair of true wireless earbuds with active noise cancellation. But the company has grander plans to send out invites for the May 18th event. The invite is ironic with "I am back" written in larger font. Below that it unveils the name of the event. Lee TV Smart Ecological Conference with a quiet vague "so what is all about." If you look closely, there is a mirrored TV 3D at the bottom right of the first invite and a mirrored VR appear a couple of times. You can see them in the second invite, whatever the event is about. It will be broadcast on the LE TV, Super TV and LE TV video platforms. LE TV, the company that transformed into Lee Echo, started life as a streaming platform. It was once seen as a China's Netflix. Among others, it is diversifying into making TVs, smartphones, smartwatches and other electronics. Judging by the invite, it is going back to its roots and it will focus on multimedia. Embattled Chinese tech giant Huawei has released several teaser posters that hint a new launch of new smart TV under a new category. The Huawei Smart Screen Software Edition looks like a trimmed down version of the high-end models and will come with more affordable pricing while retaining the premium features for which brand smart TVs are known. The teaser poster, which was slapped on Vmall and Jingdong, gives us a glimpse of the smart TVs as well as some hints of the feature to expect on board. For one, the Huawei Smart Screen Software Edition will pack a pop-up camera that will definitely function as a web camera for video calls and other related functions. The smart TV is touted to arrive in two sizes, 55-inch model that will be priced between 3099 yuan to 3999 yuan, that will be around $600, and a 65-inch version priced at 4099 yuan to 4999 yuan, that will be around $700. The Huawei P9 launched as the first phone born from Huawei and Leica partnership. Since the 2016 flagship was released, both the companies have worked together on several more Huawei phones that have set a high standard for mobile phone photography. New info says that partnership will come to an end this year. It has been revealed by TMI that the upcoming Huawei P50 series will be the last project that will have the German camera company branding. Olifone ints a new phone with an immense 13,200mAh battery. The affordable smartphone OEM Olifone has released a new teaser for an upcoming device with an extra large charge capacity. The company asserts that it will alleviate low battery anxiety and will thus be an ideal for working or power users. The new product's price or availability has yet to be revealed. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.